Geoff mentions that where trees are placed on a swale depends on the climate. Could you explain what you mean by that? How would a swale in an arid climate look different from a swale in a humid, temperate climate? Well, normally they're about the same, but in an arid climate, in a desert climate, if you have open, sandy, well-drained soil, which you often do, you can plant inside the swale. In fact, you can have swale furniture, you can have holes inside the swale to trap organic matter, you can have little planting bays in the back cut of the swale, because the trees aren't likely to drown. Open coarse sand will infiltrate water within 30 minutes. And if the water keeps coming, it's not likely to come for more than 1 to 2 days. So you can't really drown trees in 1 to 2 days. Most plants will handle 1 to 2 days of flood. But if it goes 3 to 4 days, then they'll drown. So yes, on an arid land swale, you can start planting inside the swale trench to the advantage of the establishment. But you can have fine clays. You can have sealed clay sometimes in deserts. And in that case, the mortar might stand for 3 to 4 days before it infiltrates. Now, it's going to look like the same as a temperate climate swale. You're going to have to go up onto either side of the trench or onto the low mound. You're not likely to have a really high mound in a desert landscape, but you're going to be out of the trench because you don't want to drain the trees. It is pretty rare in deserts, but there are deserts. There are plenty of situations in deserts where you get fine clays and it wets up and it seals. And it can actually take a while to infiltrate, all to the advantage of a desert, because that means it's going to hold on to the moisture for longer. So some of the times they look different, some of the times they look the same. Otherwise, more or less, most of them look very similar.